Navigating a classroom in the age of emerging technologies is filled with opportunities for English language professionals and their students. As technologies become more innovative and accessible, educators can leverage them to support their teaching and craft the classroom of the future. From personalized content to immersive virtual classrooms, technical innovation is reshaping how we teach and learn. And generative artificial intelligence, or Gen AI, is at the forefront of many of these advancements.
Generative AI has the capacity to write text, render images, construct videos, and clone voices with just a few snippets of audio. Its capacity to produce original content represents a watershed moment in how we understand the way technology functions. As a result, literacies will grow around it and its ability to both inform and misinform. We as educators need to be prepared. Whether we like it or not, teachers will be an integral part of helping our communities navigate this new world with a critical eye. We must help our students and ourselves become conscious consumers of emerging technologies, and especially AI as it becomes more embedded into the way we work and live.
The potential of emerging technologies is exciting, and it's easy to get caught up in the hype around the possibilities. But before doing so, we need to take a step back. While researchers are predicting the most common discipline for using AI will be English language education, our classrooms are not about the technologies we use, but about the students we teach, their engagement with English, and the learning experiences we design for them.
Our goal in this course isn't to make a villain of AI and other emerging technologies. In fact, we'll take a look at the incredible affordances AI can bring to our teaching practices and how it can bolster the creativity of our students. But our goal is also to understand that AI is not neutral and that adopting it into our classroom is just another cool tool may expose our students to harm. In this course, we'll take a discerning look at generative AI so that it can be a positive force for our classes, our students, and our communities.
From the time we started developing this course to its delivery, there has been a steady stream of technology advancements, most notably in the field of Gen AI. And this will continue in the future. With this in mind, we aim to provide you with the foundational knowledge required to engage with emerging technologies in ethical and informed ways, even as new developments arise. Join us in exploring the transformational possibilities of emerging technology in English language education. I'm Elizabeth Plummer.
I'm Jeff Kuhn.
And this is our Specialist Masterclass. If you've been teaching for a number of years, you've likely seen the introduction of many technologies, from whiteboards to computers to the latest web-based applications. In the field of TESOL, the term CALL, or computer-assisted language learning, was introduced at a time when computers showed a lot of potential to support language instruction. With the introduction of mobile technologies, the term MAL, or mobile-assisted language learning, came into use. More recently, the term intelligent computer-assisted language learning, or iCall, has been proposed to expand CALL to language learning with AI. Regardless of the terminology, the field of TESOL has largely embraced emerging technologies, seeing their potential to support learners in new and meaningful ways. This is prominent in the TESOL technology standards, which emphasize the skills English language professionals need to improve student learning. The four goals for language teachers are to acquire and maintain foundational knowledge and skills in technology for professional purposes, integrate pedagogical knowledge and skills with technology to enhance language teaching and learning, apply technology in record keeping, feedback, and assessment, and use technology to improve communication, collaboration, and efficiency. These skills are pedagogically focused in nature, and the students themselves are a critical part of any technology integration. As a companion to the TESOL technology standards, the International Society of Technology and Education, or ISTE, has developed standards which advocate for teachers to prepare students for a world where computing is a daily aspect of life. Educators must themselves be ongoing learners of technology, leaders in student empowerment, responsible digital citizens, collaborators in discovering technology, designers of learning experiences, facilitators of learning with technology, and data analysts to support learning outcomes. As we navigate this technologically rich world and prepare students for it, our attitudes are important. Research has found that our feelings towards technologies affect our skills in using them. That is, the more skeptical we are, the less skilled we are. Our hope is that this course will encourage you to become more skilled and thoughtful about using all technology, placing pedagogy first.
How does AI work? What do we need to know to make informed decisions about its use? Our goal here is to look behind the screen to develop literacy around AI. There are two types of AI, algorithmic and generative. Algorithmic AI has been around for years and includes Siri, Alexa, and the personalized practice and apps such as Duolingo and Babbel. It uses algorithms or probability to give human-generated answers to questions or input and pulls directly from websites, news feeds, and other sources authored by people. These initial search databases work like linguistic corpora, with words in a set sequence and algorithms determining the likelihood of the next word. This is how autocomplete works. The more words an algorithm has to work with, the stronger predictions it can make on the next word. For the phrase, "it is raining cats and," the algorithm would predict with near 100% certainty the next word would be dogs. Statistical natural language processing meant early AI programs couldn't make connections between words that are far apart in a sentence, but now they can thanks to generative AI. While algorithmic AI can suggest the next word in an email or highlight grammar and spelling mistakes in an essay, generative AI can write the entire email or essay for us. Gen AI, such as ChatGPT, Gemini, and DALL-E, refers to deep learning models that can take raw data, say all of Wikipedia or the collected works of Rembrandt, and generate new text, images, and other content when prompted. The output is not human-generated. While the AI system is drawing from human-generated content, it produces unique output through a more complex use of natural language processing and machine learning. Generative AI is based on the ability of large language models, or LLMs, to carry context and meaning across large chunks of text, thanks to tokens, vectors, and transformers. First, AI breaks words down into tokens. We can think of tokens like morphemes. They carry morphosyntactic information of words, such as prefixes or suffixes, capitalization, punctuation, or even the spaces around a word. The token information in each word gets converted into number strings called vectors. Vectors can be thousands of numbers, each carrying an attribute applied to words. Vectors place words in spatial relationships. How far apart words are represent how close a meaning they are. For example, an ambiguous word like bat will carry information related to animals and baseball, but will place that information farther apart. AI would therefore recognize that pitcher and nocturnal are not likely to be used together. How? Transformers add information to vectors by assigning weight to the characteristics they find in that word's vector map. Typically, transformers first add syntactic information to a sentence. For example, in the sentence, "Ava grabbed her bat and," AI transformers classify Ava and bat as nouns and grabbed as a verb. They also predict that after "and" will be a verb, and that verb will be related to sports or competition. As the transformer layers increase, they add more nuanced understanding, parsing out more complex features such as characters, locations, and emotional states in a short story. In much the same way a person can keep the motivations and actions of a character in mind over the course of a book chapter, AI software can track that information through vectors and transformers. As a result, Gen AI software is capable of doing something we have not seen technology do before, carry context and meaning across large chunks of text. This makes it significantly different from other forms of technology and is what enables AI software to do things like write entire essays. How are these LLMs able to do this? Researchers aren't quite sure because the calculations used by the software have become too difficult for human researchers to follow. But at its core, we know that AI can, with enough examples, begin to understand rules. If all this seems complicated, you're right. It is. Our goal here isn't to have a mastery of AI programming, but to have a basic understanding of what it is and how it works.
As we move further into the age of AI, teachers can look to foundational frameworks for integrating emerging technologies into their classrooms with pedagogy at the forefront of their decisions.
English language educators need to guide students in navigating the world around them by helping them understand how new tools and technologies work.
And emerging technologies can empower students to take charge of their own learning.